about the passion that we have for your business. And for some of you, I have seen that this morning, you know, God is big. Especially, I've been here, raise your hand if over the last year or two, you feel like when you've gone out to the business, you've been getting your teeth kicked in. Come on, come on. That's pretty much that. Have a bigger impact and to support you in overcoming a lot of the obstacles that you may have been facing over the last couple of years. So, to begin that, where you can start is actually looking at you and the role that you play in your practice, the role that you play with your clients, with your staff, with your family, with your community. And that's your role as a leader. That's what you can get. So I'm going to share with you what I call the three C's of leadership. This is a Bible. It starts at the C, with you at the center. You're at the center of the center. The first C is choice. Your choices. Choices that you make in circumstances. And a lot of times when we look at difficult choices, we forget that we actually have a choice about how we respond to them. That is one of the only things that you have is that you don't have that control over the circumstances. The only thing that you have control over is how you respond to them. And it's really easy to respond in a positive and a transcendent way when the circumstances are tough. But when those times are difficult, it's a lot more difficult for you to actually be positive. But you'll notice, if you think back and as you go forward, you look at when things come up, when obstacles come up, when difficulties come up, there will be a split second in which you're going to make a decision. You're going to go down one path, or you're going to go down the other. It's going to happen that fast. And you get to make a choice. Are you going to look at this from a positive way that you're going to get to see what is possible out of it, or are you going to become a victim of the circumstances? And it's going to happen very quickly. It's going to happen very quickly. But you are the one in charge. There's a story of a Native American grandfather who's speaking to his grandson. And as he's sharing with his grandson, he says, you know, I have got a battle. It is a loving, positive, compassionate grief. The other one is an angry, negative, vengeful grief. And the grandson says, grandfather, which wolf is going to win the battle for your heart? And the grandfather says, the one that I see. And that is exactly what it is for us. Which are you feeding? Because that's the only thing that you have control over. Are you feeding that positive or are you feeding the negative? So that is the choice. The second C is commitment. You have to make a commitment day by day, event by event, moment by moment. When you are faced with difficulties, what's your commitment? How are you going to see things? Because you are the one that has to say, I am going to see things from a different point of view. It takes a commitment to say, I am going to see things from a different point of view. But here's the bad news when you make that commitment. You will be tested. Have you ever noticed that? As soon as you make a commitment, let's see if you really mean it. So that's what you're going to do. It's going to be tested to see if you really do. And when you get tested, trusted. You made that choice, you made that commitment, you actually trusted the promise of God. That then leads you to the third C that is leadership, and that is capability. And I will tell you that I think that this capability, this leadership capability, and you being able to see things from a different point of view, not to be a victim, but being able to be positive in the light of difficult circumstances, is one of your most important leadership capabilities. Now, if you don't believe me, look at your own heart. Think of the people that you are drawn to. Who do you want to spend your time with? And who is it that you want to get as far away from as you possibly can? Any of those people who are always negative, like they're always like, no matter what it is, something's wrong. Like they can never quite get even good. And then there are other people. And these can be people who are facing extreme, dire, difficult circumstances. And when you're with them, you feel uplifted. You feel better. Capability I'm talking about. This is not a denial of fact. This is not being Pollyanna wearing rose-colored glasses. That is not what I'm talking about. This is a capability of recognizing facts and saying, you know what? There's another way of dealing with this. And when you operate in that way, what happens is people are drawn to you like bees to honey. It makes selling so easy because you don't have to sell. You draw people to you just by who you are and how you operate. They want to be around you. That's the kind of leadership that I'm talking about. So, I don't think that sounds like a good idea. How do you do it? First one, go on a media diet. Have you noticed that negativity is in the media? Anybody in here notice that? Well, there's a reason for it. There's a reason for it. Newspapers need to sell newspapers.